I have two questions, one on communications and Turkey.
Okay.
I'm wondering whether the United States changed its attitude on surveillance of its allies or monitoring its allies. So I'm asking this because there are allegations. After the surveillance of the Angela Merkel's phone by the United States Intelligence Service, the United States administration stated that U.S. will so conclude those surveillance activities against the NATO allies. However, there are claims that the Turkey and the President Erdogan are exceptions on this case because of the reason to get able to follow the radical groups in Syria. So my first question is, the United States changed its attitude on surveillance of its allies? And second is, what is your consideration of those allegations on Turkey? Turkey is another ally, so Turkey an exception for those surveillance activities?
First of all, that's a very loaded question. First of all, in response to have we changed our surveillance techniques or approach to surveillance, President Obama has spoken to this multiple occasions since some of the revelations out of Edward Snowden's criminal actions, and I think spoken about how we're going to conduct ourselves very frankly and very openly. I'm not going to attempt to parse that or change that. That still stands. In terms of your specific allegations about President Erdogan, I've never heard of such allegations. I won't speak to beyond that what our intelligence activities may be. I'm not speaking with respect to Turkey, certainly, but in general. Turkey is a valued NATO ally. It is a member of the anti-ISIL coalition. And we're working in close, closely with Turkey in driving ISIL from Syria and from Iraq. We value their input, their participation in the anti-ISIL coalition, and we have again a very close relationship with them. We share information with them, so there's no reason to believe that we would ever conduct ourselves in that way.